This is a group of four original Egyptian lithographic movie posters from the 1950s and 1960s. They were creased and damaged, so we gave them a poster fix. Hi, I'm Chris, and welcome to Poster Fix Studio. This is our first video in the new year, 2022. If you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do so. Hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell. Poster Fix is the only place where you can see the restoration of a vintage poster week after week. These four Egyptian movie posters were not always this nice and flat. If we go back in time, we can see that they were damaged and folded.
When these three Egyptian posters came to us, they were in nice condition, but...
Let's see, we got the amphibious man here with heavy folio creases, but there's no stains. There's a little bit of paper damage up in the corner, which we're gonna fix later. The color is beautiful. The lithography, this is one thing that's very interesting, is that they are all printed in lithography. Probably, this one is for King Kong Escapes. Probably metal plates though, not stone plates. But it's interesting that they keep using lithographic printing in Egypt. It makes for some beautiful stuff. Here's the Rikisha man, also in lithography. A little bit of damage here, but pretty good overall. These three posters are going to get linen back.
We have to prepare a screen to mount these posters. Using wheat paste, we're going to cover this acid-free paper all over the place with the wheat paste and make sure that there are no dry spots anywhere. Then we lift the paper and place it down onto the stretched canvas. This canvas is cotton canvas. Hercules puts the screen on the table and starts to expand the paper. And then using a roller, Hercules pushes out the excess air pockets and wheat paste.
Well, now we've got this screen all prepared, and now we're going to mount these posters, which we'll do after this commercial break, so don't go away.
My dad wanted me to tell you that if you or your parents have any questions about restoring old posters, send my dad an email. Tell him what the poster is, send a few pictures, and he'll get back to you on recommendations of what you can do to restore it. We look forward to seeing your posters.
We're back in the Poster Fix shop, and these four Egyptian posters are about to be linen-backed. We have just prepared this stretcher screen with acid-free paper, and we're ready to go.
Okay, I think I can put this amphibious man here. King Kong Escapes here. These are slightly smaller than American one sheets. Let's see, I think these posters are strong enough that I can put the wheat paste directly to the poster. Although the paper is thin, it's different paper than what we get with American posters or French posters. Wheat paste directly to the poster. And as I do that, the paper begins to expand because paper is porous. This paper is just as porous as any other kind. Now I'm passing over it again with 1 second coating of wheat paste to make sure that it's very good and covered, and also because now that the poster is stretched out and expanded, it probably could use it. All right, so now I'm gonna flip it. Ooh, the paper is very thin and it's wet. It takes a lot of experience to handle wet paper. Let me see if I can lift it again.
Now I'm spraying it with water.
So that it will expand more and be more pliable and stretch out better. Posters because of the lithography.
King Kong escapes. I'm now taking a roller, this roller, and I'm gently pushing out the air pockets and excess wheat paste to make sure that the poster hugs the canvas.
King Kong Escapes is a 1967 kaiju film directed by Ishiro Honda with special effects by Eiji Tsuburaya. The film was a Japanese-American co-production between Toho and Rankin Bass. The film is loosely based on Rankin Bass's series, The King Kong Show, and was the second and final Toho-produced films featuring King Kong. King Kong Escapes was released in Japan on July 22, 1967, and released in the United States in 1968. Amphibian Man is a 1962 Soviet science fiction romance film starring Vladimir Korenev and directed by Vladimir Chebotaryov and Gennady Kazansky. The film stars Vladimir Korenev and Anastasia Vertinskaya in the lead roles. It is an almost fable-like story based upon the eponymous 1928 novel by Alexander Believ. It focuses on a youth who was surgically altered to survive under the sea. Unlike traditional science fiction movies of the time, the film focuses much more on the concept of love won and lost. It was given the name of Tarzan de Mers before the estate of Edgar Rice Burroughs took exception. That means Tarzan of the Sea. The film was the leader of Soviet distribution in 1962, with 65.5 million admissions during its initial run that year. It later sold up to 100 million admissions, including reruns, the highest for a Soviet film up until the Red Snowball Tree of 1974. These four Egyptian movie posters are all printed in lithography as opposed to offset printing. By the 1960s, most other countries, with possibly the exception of Australia, had given up on using lithography as a commercial printing method and preferred offset. Certainly as early as the 1930s, American movie posters had ceased to be printed in lithography, in preference to offset photographic printing.
Okay, I've got these two linen-backed, and now we got to linen-back this one, which you will see after this commercial break. So don't go away. Okay, so I'm going to take this one over to the screen and lay it down here. This is where it's going to go, right next to the amphibious man. Amphibian man. Why do I keep saying amphibious? Sort of the man from Atlantis sort of thing. All right. Mm-hmm.
this thin paper from Egypt expands very quickly once you put the wheat paste on it. So I don't have to wait very long before flipping it around. Which I'm going to do now.
Directed by Hiroshi Inagaki, The Rikisha Man, also known as The Rickshaw Man. A simple Rikisha Man falls in love with the beautiful mother of a young boy he has befriended, but knows he can never have her because of their class difference. One of the reviews reads, "The lead actor of this film is known to have played samurai roles in previous films. Toshiro Mifune trades samurai garb for sun hat and sandals in Rikisha Man. Mifune plays an impoverished, illiterate rickshaw puller in the Japan of the early 20th century. Preferring to stay aloof from the rest of humanity, Mifune nonetheless touched by the plight of a young boy whose soldier father has been killed. In acting as a surrogate father to the boy, Mifune falls in love with the lad's mother, played by Hideko Takamine. But the woman is far, far above the rickshaw man's social class, and Mifune is tragically denied the happiness he so richly deserves." This is Inagaki's 1958 remake of a film he originally made in 1943.
Oopsie-daisy, I just found a fourth Egyptian poster here for Legend of Dinosaurs and Monster Birds. It's a great piece of artwork, though. And it's lithography. We're going to linear back this. This has got a lot more damage on it, though. It's got water staining in these margins and paper missing, although some of it is folded underneath. So let's see what we can do with this poster on a linear backing.
Okay, it fits well in this spot. So I think I'm going to do the same thing I did before, apply the wheat paste directly to it.
Legend of Dinosaurs and Monster Birds, also known in the U.S. as The Legend of Dinosaurs, is a 1977 Japanese science fiction film produced and distributed by Toei Company. A young woman wanders barefoot in the lush area of Japan, also known as the Sea of Trees region of Mount Fuji, and suddenly falls into a cavern, awakening an icy cave full of large eggs. When one of the eggs starts to hatch, she goes into hysterics and flees until she is discovered by a construction crew. Before falling into a coma, the girl babbles about what she saw to a reporter. Her story airs on televised news reports that is seen by geologist Takashi Ashizawa. Upon hearing about the fossilized egg, Takashi sets off to Mount Fuji to find it. Anyway, the story goes on from there.
Okay, I've got this screen loaded with four Egyptian movie posters. We're gonna have to let this screen dry. Okay, a day has passed, and my wife Oki is going to go in to this poster and put the paper fills here, as well as do a little bit of work on this poster here in the corner. And then once she's done those paper fills, we'll let it dry for another day or two.
Foreign movies in Egypt provide both a stimulus for the local culture and the impetus for the nascent film industry. Egypt was one of the few countries the Lumiere brothers visited to demonstrate their new invention, the cinematograph, with the first purpose-built cinema house opening in 2007. Foreign films are fast becoming a regular event that the local cultural milieu is becoming accustomed to. However, foreign movies in Egypt are not only foreign in their language, but also extravagant in their context, social mores, and themes. When foreign movies are brought into Egypt, they require translation, as very few movies are shown in their original language.
This is a Japanese movie released in Egypt. You can burnish this though. How many posters do you have here? Three? Okay, yeah. No, well, you can fit the, all right, fix the bubble. What? What?
We need a new box of this grade.
Hold it up to the camera.
This is the last LV I've used for a long time.
Okay. We need a box of those.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah.
Use the tool, please. You are Homo sapiens.
I'm not.
You are not? Okay.
Thank you. Okay. Okay.
That's it?
Yeah.
It up for today's segment of Poster Fix. I appreciate your joining me and look forward to seeing you here next time. Thank you.